YouTube search for
Promise Federation.
Watch on your big screen.
Or another device if you're at home.
Get yourself comfy, this could take a while. What a happy scene. Something new every day for your long-term memory. This is so exciting, it is nearly time for a
forest
assembly. Hello everyone, and welcome to Monday and our Forest Federation Welcome to the Week assembly. This is where I talk to Newton children and families, I talk to Stukeley children and families, we talk about the week that's coming up, we get excited for learning, and we talk about what you've been up to and what you've got coming up. Okay, six short words that drive our lives. Every single day in our schools, we want children and staff to feel, be and become. Our school motto is, our school curriculum is. Brilliant. Right, everyone, I hope you had a good weekend. I hope you had some safe firework and bonfire fun, if that's what you're doing. And if it's not your thing, if you don't enjoy it, I hope you still had a relaxed time and it didn't worry you too much. Let's talk about what's going on this week. Okay, everyone, we've got a really busy week. We've always got a busy week. So this week, we've got all clubs starting back at Newton this week. We've got the PSS clubs, we've got some other bits and bobs. We've definitely got Mulkey on Wednesday morning and table tennis on Thursday morning. Brand new indoor Mulka coming to you this week, Newton. And Stukeley, Tuesday morning, brand new indoor Mulka coming to you. I don't want to give you too much away, but I've made indoor Mulka out of a pool noodle. Yes, I have. I've taken a pool noodle and a hacksaw and a permanent marker, and I have made our very own indoor Mulka. Looking forward to that. Also, we've got families coming to look around Newton on Wednesday afternoon and Stukeley on Thursday evening. Families coming to look around for their children starting school in September next year. So we're looking forward to seeing what we do really well. We've got some year five, year six footy tournaments going on this week at Stukeley. We've also got the street artist back in at Stukeley this week because we got rained off last week. Hey Newton, have you seen that new bit of street art that Abide has put into the foyer? Isn't it great? Yeah, thought so. Anyway, and also on Friday, it's Remembrance Day. We've got some bits going on at Newton and we've got some bits and some walks going on at Stukeley. So loads going on. Thank you, teachers. Thank you, staff now and children for helping to get ready for a busy week. Right, let's move on. Talk about curriculum. Right, okay, let's start off with Newton curriculum. I'm going to go fast, so listen in. And in class, you are cracking on with your train ride learning and you're going to start sentence stacking. That's something that both schools are going to start doing lots more of now. Year ones, you're adding and subtracting in your maths foundation. You're still looking at 1, 2, and 3 and you're doing great work on that. Year ones, you're mainly focusing on your takeaway part in your maths this week. In art, you're making your mark. Not going to say too much about that. All I know is that you're getting your sketchbooks out, you're exploring line. In RE, you're talking about religious symbols as part of different faiths, and you're reading A Tiger Who Came to Tea, and you're looking at what we know about the story from the clues that we've got. You're doing lots of retrieval. It's going to be great. You've also got Forest School this week, Anning. Loads to get excited about. Good old class. Busy week for you too. You're carrying on with your Star in a Jar, your own versions. So let's have some really, really good focus in your writing this week. Year twos, you're adding and subtracting in your maths. Year threes are doing the same with two-digit numbers. And year fours, you are looking at area. So different focus to number this week for you. In science, Year twos are cracking on with Mrs. Stevens again this week. Year three, four, you're looking at forces and magnets, talking about what a force is, and what effect it has, and what then happens after that. In your geography, you're carrying on with your river learning, looking at erosion, transportation, and deposition. I mean, that's big stuff. Year twos, you're cracking on Mrs. Stevens, you're looking at your transport history. And in computing, you are coding with algorithms. Yes, you are good old Einstein. Once again, busy, busy week coming up. You are persuading in your English, you're protesting about the environment. Loads on that in news at the moment. Enjoy when you get there. In maths, year fives, you are multiplying and dividing. Year six, you're cracking on with the four operations. And there's a bit of cube numbering there as well, just to make things tricky, tricky. Geography, year five, six, you're looking at biomes and why they are where they are. So why do they match the places that they are? It's e-safety in computing, talking about your own private details. This is a massive, massive part of e-safety, keeping your information to yourself. It could be dangerous if you don't. And in science, you're looking at different types of energy. Wow, Stukely Meadow. Starting off with Juniper and Rowan, you are looking at the B-f-oo sounds this week. They're your phonics this week. You're reading individual letters by saying the sound that they make. That's what you're doing. And I think you might be doing some letter names as well. We'll get onto that. Maths, you are comparing different sets of objects. You're talking about more than, fewer than, and equal to. That's what you're doing this week, foundation stage in maths. You're understanding the world and talking about Remembrance Day and why it's an important thing for us to keep coming back to each year. You're sharing and taking turns in your PSED. Some of us find that tricky, even adults find that tricky. And you're talking about the importance of that in our daily lives. You've got some forest school as well this week on Monday, and you are going to be cracking on with practicing your nativity play. We cannot wait. Year one, Not Now Bernard, you're cracking on with that, and you're writing your story sentences. You've been doing some really good work on that last week. You're subtracting in your maths, you're taking away, talking about how many left, and you're going to be doing lots of crossing out. Crossing out is good though. Don't worry too much about it. In history, you've got a bit of a quiz on homes through time. How much have you remembered? What more do we need to know? And in your science, you're talking about living things. What do all living things do? You're going to tell me at the end of the week. Year three. No. No, no, no. Year two. In your English, you're carrying on with your Paddington learning. You're talking about the bit where he meets Mr. and Mrs. Brown on the railway platform. Lots of good introduction writing there, year twos. In your maths, you're subtracting. You're taking away two-digit numbers. Lots of hard work going on there. In history, you're looking at changes in living memory. You're talking about transport. Lots of really interesting knowledge to get about how transport's moved on. In art, you're carrying on with your pop art, you're looking at simple sculptures, and in your music, we've got your second session of your Mrs. Nightingale video resource. I think Mrs. Hunt and Miss Smart are quite pumped for leading that. They were quite excited about that last week. Year three, you've got your poetry carrying on in your English, you're looking at personifying autumn. In your maths, you're subtracting with exchange across tens and 100s. Something we did a bit on last week, but you're subtracting this week. UK regions is your geography. You're looking at all about our region, which is East Anglia. Rocks, carrying on your science work. You're looking at the permeability of the three main rock types. What does permeable mean? You tell me, and then we'll investigate different rock types. And Charlotte's Web, you're on chapter six now, and you're looking for more evidence to explain what you know. Year four. Feast. Loved it last week, right? We knew you would. Mrs. Davis, who teaches in year six, she knew you'd love it too. You're writing about your feelings as part of Feast this week. You're multiplying and dividing, and you're using the three times table. In your Romans learning, you're looking at what they've done for us. What do we now do because of the Romans? In science, you're cracking on with your sound topic, looking at instruments and seeing vibrations. Are we putting rice on a drum, Mr. Smith? I really hope we are. Or Mrs. Franklin. And then you've got more Lowry learning of perspective. I saw some brilliant tweets year four this week, last week, with some of your final images. I mean, truly wonderful. Year five, you are looking at journal writing inspired by Scott of the Antarctic. You're writing about feelings and experiences in the Antarctic. If you've never been, think your teachers have got some ideas about how to experience it. Fractions is your maths. You're converting improper fractions to mixed numbers and vice versa. I've been doing that with my daughter this morning. It's Sunday today, as part of her home learning. Sikhism is your focus in RE. Who are the 10 gurus? Now, if you're in year six, you'll remember doing this last year, hopefully. You're changing materials in your science, looking at solubility, and in computing, you're cracking on with your scratch music. And finally, year six, big week for you. Charles Darwin biography writing, independent work, and editing. You are fractions, decimals, and percentaging in your maths, and you're going to be adding and subtracting fractions as a main focus in your science. Oak class are looking at different beaks on birds and why. And Sycamore are looking at the circulatory system. Yes, they are. And in your history, more industrial revolution. What a brilliant period of time. You're looking at the steam engine as an invention. And that is absolutely brilliant. Right, finish there. Quick chat about home learning.
Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. This is home learning. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. This is a home learning.
Okay, everyone. Read, write, quiz, spell, calculate. Mrs. Mackey from Stukely Meadows prints off for me every week people's quiz scores and quiz results. I haven't got somebody doing that at Newton yet, but that's going to come up soon. You should be reading five times a week. You should be writing in your learning logs. You should all now have another kind of pretend one. I know it's frustrating about the others, partly my fault, but they're almost here. Be an early Christmas present when they come. Quizzing, you should all be doing your AR. Calculation through Rockstars and Numbots, and your spellings and your phonics practice. They're the five things we asked you to do at home. Right, let's move on to, you know what, create a challenge. It was a good one. Look at this.
I'm not afraid to die.
Brilliant work, Mrs. Page. Thank you so much for that. Another, well, as the sun goes down, what a wonderful theme. Looking forward to seeing that one play itself out. Come on, Newton. Come on, Stukely. Get your photos tweeted in or emailed in, and let's get another brilliant creative challenge done. Okay, we're going to finish up now with birthdays.
Hey, 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 it's time to say, let's celebrate a birthday. Hey, 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 it's time to say, let's celebrate a birthday. Come on!
Right, I'm excited today. We've got lots of Federation birthdays. Yes, we have. Today, Noah, year 5, and Zach, year 4, from Newton, happy birthday. Lila Sue from year 3, Izzy from Foundation Stage, and Beau from year 5 at Stukely, happy birthday. Then, the rest of the week, tomorrow, we've got Finn, year 4, Mason, year 2, and George in year 1, all three at Newton's birthday. Bearing in mind there's not a huge amount of children in the school, 3 on one day is incredible. Also, we've got Kieran in year 6's birthday coming up the next few days as well from Newton, as well as Annabella from year 1, Ellie from year 5, Emily D from year 3, Garrett from year 4, and Riley from year 5, all from Stukely. It's your birthday too. Have a wonderful day when it comes along. Right, coming up, you have got Get In. It's a great video. Watch it straight after this if you can. You've also got an everyday knowledge, but most importantly, today every child in the Forest Federation is getting their credit card. Hopefully you remember this. It's a little card with 25 boxes on it. Every time you do something which is more than what we expect, so coming into class silently, working hard in your maths, being polite in the dinner hall, doing your reading for home learning, we expect you to do them. But when you do them very, very well all the time and you show us that you're making progress and you're getting your best better, then you'll be getting a stamp on your credit card. You'll get a diagonal line first, which means money off some stationery in the bookshop. You'll get another diagonal line next, which means a little bit more. And then all of your horizontal and vertical lines are all 25 pence each. And that means bookshop time. It's going to be great. Anyway, looking forward to getting them started. We're working hard, we're being kind, we're aiming high. See you soon.